Dirt roads to rock crawling, two-buck chuck to screaming eagle, moonshine to 50-year-old single malt. We talk about it all here on Wheelin' Wine and Whiskey with your hosts, Jason and Chris.
Welcome to Wheelin' Wine and Whiskey, episode 166. Pair of sixes.
166?
With an ace. Three-card poker.
Wow.
All right, Chris, how you doing?
I'm good. I'm getting better.
Another episode.
Yeah, another.
Nobody wants to hear about your health issues. No. Nobody wanted to hear about my health issues and all our old man problems, apparently.
No.
So,
hey, you know,
you're alive. I'm alive.
A lot of our listeners are getting old, too.
I survived the endoscopy, colonoscopy. It was actually painless. They had me out. I've never been out for the endoscopy. I've always been like kind of like Twilight, like Tyler after sipping on, you know, a half a bottle of Fireball by the campfire at Meadow Lake. I was kind of in that kind of twilight.
Was that a full bottle?
But didn't hurl.
Shit.
But no, they totally knocked me out. So it was like a half an hour in, out, and done. So there you go. So
no pun intended.
I'm alive. I'm well. And there you have it. I'm able to eat solid food again, which is a great thing.
Yeah.
And we got some pork tenderloin on the grill right now with
looking
some
forward to it.
Corn on the cob. Woo! And it's on the smoker.
Wheelin' Wine and Whiskey, eating good in the studio.
Got one of those little Davy Crockett Green Mountain
smoker.
Green Mountain Grill, GMG.
So it's a little pellet
yeah,
grill.
Yeah, it's a 12-volt grill. Yeah. Did I talk about this before on the podcast? I don't think so.
Yeah, I
modified it.
You modified it.
I modified it.
More power. So is it a Binford now?
It is. So I converted it to 240 volt.
Three phase?
Yeah, so it cooks a lot faster now. It's like an induction microwave cooktop.
Perfect.
Deal. Don't ask Jimmy because he couldn't explain it to you. But it has a, it's 12 volts. So, you know, you have your converter that converts from 110 to 12 volt. And it was kind of bulky, and it's like one more thing to carry. So there was enough room underneath the hopper where all the electronics are to mount it up in there. So I mounted it up in there and put the cord out. So now you can just plug it in like a normal appliance.
So it's like a hybrid.
It is. And then,
Prius.
And then it had a cigarette lighter, which is just, that was like so 2000 and late.
Uh-huh.
So I modified it with a... I call them GM connectors, but the actual WeatherTight connectors that, you know, is like a vehicle plug connector that's waterproof, mm-hmm. snaps together, very positive.
Locks.
So I put that adapter on there, cleaned that all up, got rid of the cigarette deal. So anyways, it's working out great. So I'm planning on bringing it to Trek. So
cool.
Smoke up some meat after we get all that fine food out there at the big event, which we've already talked about, and you need to get signed up for that if you haven't, if you're planning on going.
Definitely sign up, because the signups for, if you want to be up there and you can and get food, you need to sign up. The cutoff for that is July 31st.
July 31st, yes. So you've got some time from listening from this podcast to get signed up.
But it's rapidly approaching. So
some of the runs I know are getting close to filling up. So
that's right.
If you want to get in, make it happen, because you know, everybody's kind of waiting around to see what's going on. Fuel prices going down. You know, are the rigs going to run? Especially the Toyota guys. You know, they don't know if they're going to have a rig.
That's
so
right.
Why should I sign up if I don't know if my rig's not going? But all the Jeep people that listen to this podcast are like, yeah, I know my Jeep's going to be running. So I've already signed up. So
that's right. That's
you Toyota guys, get on the ball and get signed up. We'd love to see you up
that's
there.
Right. You don't need much fuel. I mean, you only have a 10-gallon gas tank in those things anyway. So.
And we're going to have a booth up there. We're not going to be in it 24/7, but we'll be around. You can find us in camp.
Yep.
But we'll be up there, looking forward to it. Weather's going to be freaking spectacular. The lake is full.
Oh, that's good to hear.
The road is supposed to be epic going in there right now. The county did some work, so it's nice and smooth.
That sharp turn they fixed, it was washed out.
Yeah, it was all washed out. So, you can literally get a semi-truck trailer in there, because that's what they do, bringing in the food and stage and all that stuff. So, you know, it's a little sketchy in Toyotas. But everybody else, no problem. You can get in.
What about Samurais?
Samurais, no problem.
No problem.
Yeah, they're the short wheelbase. You know, they can maneuver around pretty good. So
gotcha.
Yeah. So, get signed up, cal4wheel.com. Cal4Wheel.com or org? .com.
Cal4Wheel.com.
Okay, Cal4Wheel.com, Sierra Trek 2022, August 11th through the 14th.
It's coming right around the corner, 3 weeks.
Be there or be square.
Yeah, it's going to be awesome.
Yeah, so looking forward to that. Other housekeeping, we got a voicemail that we wanted to play last time, but we didn't have the Roadcaster. We have the Roadcaster fired up right now.
Boy, that was a challenge. I tell you, I've been kind of off in a daze. I don't know if it's my
dazed and confused,
my like post-COVID Led freaking Zeppelin. Brain fog or what, but I arrived down here at Studio S. What was this?
We call this Studio S? What's the S stand for?
SJ San Jose.
Oh, well. Oh, we just call it the home studio.
The home studio. That's where it started. Home studio. Okay, whatever. But I forgot to bring the power cord.
Yeah, I'm talking on the phone with Amber Turner, and Chris comes out and he goes, "We got some bad news." And I'm like, "Whoa, what happened?" I mean, you know, you've had a hell of a week. So I'm like, "What's wrong now?" And then you go, "Oh, missing the power cord." I'm like, "Well, that is a problem."
Because we needed to be able to plug in the phone.
We have versatility, so we're running off a USB right now.
Yeah, when I bought the Roadcaster,
it's like overlanding right now.
I included the USB power cord. Yeah,
the Wagon Tech power source.
That's right. Looking for sponsors.
We don't have the Batwing canopy deployed, or the traction boards, or the scuttle going. We got a pellet smoker.
No, but the Roadcaster is.
We don't have our Crocs on.
Plugged into a wall wart that provides USB to our Roadcaster. Yeah. So super cool.
And it's green power here in San Jose too.
Always have a backup plan is what I say. So if we couldn't get this thing fired up, we'd be using the Zoom. But
we've learned that over the years of four wheeling. Always have a plan B to your plan A.
Absolutely. Right? So yeah, we're continuing on with the show. So yeah, we've got a voicemail to play.
We do. So as promised, Chris Farley called in. It's always
Chris
classic.
Farley again. He's a fan of the show. That's awesome. Go.
So this is great.
Hello, my name is Matt Farley, and I am a motivational speaker. Now it occurs to me that I haven't called in quite a while because I've been spending time outside in the nature, or as I like to call it, nature, because it's really neat. Okay, so there's a couple things I want to address here. One, the most important thing is you're creeping up on 200 episodes, and I think that's a great milestone. For you and that other guy. Which other guy, I don't know. But he thinks he's Mr. Funny Pants with his sounds and all of his things going on the internet. Anyway, a great idea for you for episode 200 would be a mashup of all your celebrity guests, myself, and Corey. Now, don't call me a producer on this, but I do want a little credit. Okay? Fine. Also, it occurs to me that Lorenzo has been out and about, most recently spotted with the dogs at the Grand Canyon.
Now, the Grand Canyon.
Lorenzo is a popular person in this environment. He's loved by all, so stop giving him a hard time. Exactly. Okay. Now, moving right along, the third part to this diatribe of awesomeness that I have given you is this. Quit hating on the Toyota. Nobody likes you with your little fancy pants saying Toyotas always have their hoods up or Toyotas are always here where Jeeps can't go. Because we all know you can fix a Jeep with a can of hairspray and a blowtorch. Thank you, and I look forward to your next podcast.
Okay, so diatribe of awesomeness.
A can of hairspray and a blowtorch?
A can of hairspray and a blowtorch is all you need to fix a Jeep. That's freaking great.
That's freaking awesome.
Oh, Farley, thank you for calling in. Always welcome. Anytime you want to be on the podcast. We are coming up on the 200th episode, which is mind-boggling. I have no idea what we're going to do, but it's going to be of epic proportions.
Sometime this fall or winter, yeah. We can map it. I haven't even sat and looked at the calendar for that.
No, we just got to get through summer. We just got to make it through summer.
I know, right? We're
just one day at a time here, Chris. But yeah, that is... That is freaking epic, man. Diatribe of awesomeness. And Nietzsche. It is neat.
It is neat.
Especially up there in Meadow Lake.
That's right.
It is neat.
That's right.
Sierra Trek 2022. Looking forward to it. Well, all right, Mr. Farley. I hope to see you soon. I know the rumor is that you're going to be a Trail Hero 2022.
Is that true?
Yeah.
Cool.
So looking forward to him. That's where we recorded the soundbite, the opening that he did down there for us. So
that's right.
That's freaking so good. Classic. Always classic from Chris Farley. So, you know, we got to circle back with Schwarzenegger. We haven't heard back from him in a while. And
Or Bill, is Bill Cosby in jail right now?
I think he's dead. Yeah, I think
Cosby's gone. He might be dead. Wow. I don't think he is, but okay.
Jail, dead.
Jell-O pudding pops. Come on, man.
Jell-O pudding pops. Wow, anyways.
You did pretty good with
thank
that.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very little. Well, anyways, so there we go. So before we get into our other voicemails, we got some other stuff to cover here, but we are going to circle back with Gear Wrench Corey, you know, threw us under the bus for our phone line for a deck collection here for Colin.
We say Allen wrenches.
Allen wrenches, hex keys, Allen wrenches, and channel locks, something. I don't know. I can't remember. It's so long ago.
I used Allen wrenches at work the other day.
Yeah?
A bunch of them.
Okay. They're great.
Yeah, I mean.
I name all my wrenches, you know, John, Bob, Chuck, Allen.
They're good wrenches.
Ellen.
Wow.
Susie.
Female wrenches now?
Robbie Ratchet.
Are those wenches?
Donnie Deadblow. Hammer. That's my favorite.
The every tool is a hammer.
Every tool can be a hammer. Exactly right.
I was banging on shit with an adjustable Allen wrench the other day.
All right. You're going to like this story. So I worked on my F-350, the tow rig, right? So I wanted the brakes. I knew it. I mean, I've worked on vehicles long enough, and I'm like, you know what? My rear pads, I don't know why, because usually your front pads wear out before, but that's the rear correct. Pads on my truck were getting low a while back, like over a year ago, and they still had probably 10, 15,000 miles on it. I do a lot of towing in that truck. When I drive it, it's typically towing or, you know, heavy load.
Right. As we all do with our big trucks.
Yeah, and it's got the exhaust brake and the transmission. It downshifts. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's not like you're riding the brakes down hills and stuff, but it's towing heavy loads. Anyways, put new pads on it, and I just went down to O'Reilly and got basic pads, threw them on just to have more meat before I went to Trail Hero last year.
Right.
So that was in October, right? So that must have been, into summer, September, I probably did it. So anyways, and ever since I did that, of course, I didn't turn the rotors or anything. So I made it up, you know, brand new pads with old rotors.
Right.
And that's a big no-no. And it never was great.
Didn't bite well?
It was good, but not great.
Did it shudder at all?
It felt like a Dodge. It felt like hitting brakes, you know, on a Dodge. You know, that's probably what it felt like.
Really?
I got to imagine. You know, I've never driven a Dodge, but I got to imagine that's kind of what it feels like. You're just kind of hoping that it slows down. You know, I really? Don't know. No, is it like that?
Dude, my brakes are badass.
Oh, okay.
This thing's clamped.
That's
like
right, because
business.
You can't go anywhere. So with stopping is a lot easier to stop from 40 miles an hour than from 80 miles.
Wow,
anyway,
really? So. I put OEM brake pads on. I love them. They're great.
So power stop I had on my old truck, my 99 F-350 power stop brakes, and they make a towing package. It's not inexpensive, but you know, what's the price of brakes, having good brakes. So, I wanted to do their towing package, the slotted rotors and brake pads. So I got brake pads, front rear, got the slotted rotors for the rear, but the fronts are just, you know, they're so far back ordered. Like, you know, you may see them in 6 months. I mean, nobody has them. I checked everywhere.
Okay.
So they're done out there. Or they're sitting on a container ship somewhere out in the Atlantic.
Oh, no,
so
those days are over. The container ships are rolling through.
Are they?
Unloading like crazy.
Okay. All right. Good. Well, whatever it is, they're
just not supporting Ford anymore.
They're not existing. That could be. So I put the rears on, new slotted rotors, brake pads, fronts. I put brand new stock rotors back on. I could have had them turned, but it's like, you know, time, money. I don't know. I don't even know who turns rotors anymore here in the Bay Area. There's got to be somebody.
Napa.
Yeah, they might. You know, yeah,
at least Napa and Livermore's got a machine
shop. Yeah, I don't know.
It's got the old grizzled, freaking gnarly, knuckled machinists, you know?
Yeah.
Guys that are all like 800 years old, like Yoda.
Yeah, because they're the only ones that know how to run those machines anymore, because exactly. The millennials have no interest in running those machines.
That's right.
So put it all back together, and then you got to bed them in, right?
Right.
So you got to do these five stops from 40 miles an hour down to 10 repeatedly, and then you go from 30 miles an hour down to 5 repeatedly, times.
Now, before you do that, remember that before you even leave the driveway, you need to apply your brakes to make sure you seat the... Some people forget to do that, and they have no fucking brakes when they leave the driveway.
Okay, so what you're referring to is when you're putting on new brake pads or working on your brakes, and you compress the calipers.
Right.
Right? So you push the calipers in so it's easier to get around the two new brake pads that are thicker.
Correct.
Right? So you're pushing that extra fluid back up in there, yeah, so when you go to apply your brakes the first time, it goes to the floor.
You got
to do like 2-3 pumps, and then it finally comes back up as the
right.
fluid gets back down and the pressure equalizes in all the brakes, right? Yeah. No, I knew that. I've done this enough times. Not my first rodeo there. So, it was great. Did the break-in procedure to evenly apply the brake pad material to the rotors. And I'll tell you what, man. Those fucking brakes are night and day difference from the old ones. Night and day.
Sweet.
So good.
All right, cool.
So that was the upgrade. I put new fuel filters in. There's two fuel filters on the newer Ford. So there's one right by the fuel tank, a big cartridge filter. And I bought a while back, thank God, because, man, just to, you know, everybody's seen the price increases and stuff. So there's a billet aluminum on the stock one is a plastic yellow drain valve to drain off water and fuel out of the fuel filter there. And people have, you know, said that they snap off and then, you know, you're screwed. You got to find the part. You know, a lot of people carry an extra one in their glove compartment. And so I said, well, one day I was like, oh, I might as well just buy that. So I've had it for like 5-6 months, this part.
Okay.
Nice green billet aluminum piece to replace that plastic piece. And so I put that in and I checked on the price and it was $32 more expensive over 5-6 months ago.
Wow.
Yeah. I was like, well, holy smokes.
Inflation, baby.
And then I put the filter in. There's one right above the engine there. And then there's a return line on the 17 and up Fords that is notorious. It's a plastic, you know, fitting going into a rubber hose, and that fitting breaks off and then you're screwed.
God, everything in my truck's metal.
Well, yeah. Mm-hmm. So anyways,
just saying,
I bought an aftermarket piece for that from SPE as well. SPE was the drain, cock there. We'll call it, that's on the bottom of the truck. Yeah. Okay, Tyler. And so I put that in. So, you know, pressure tested everything. It's great. Been driving it around. So that's done. And then the other piece of the puzzle was lug nuts. So one thing I will say that Ford fucked up on is they've got like these two-piece lug nuts on the trucks.
I've heard about those. Yeah.
And, you know, so I had new tires put on my truck. That was after Trail Hero. So that was a year and a half ago, 2 years ago, something like that. Anyways, and, you know, of course, you know, America's Tire, and I mean, they're pretty good, but they're using guns and stuff. Da, 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 and they're all deformed.
I can't
fit. It's supposed to be a 13/16 socket or a 21 millimeter socket that goes on there.
Uh-huh.
Couldn't get it on.
Really?
So I had to use the stock tire iron would get on there, and a couple of them I had to hammer it on. And I'm like, okay, I'm in my driveway, you know, controlled environment, fine, whatever. But I'm like, no, this is not good if I have to change a tire out on the highway. So I'm looking around for aftermarket lug nuts. Of course, none of the stores around here have them because it's a flat flange lug nut. It's not tapered.
It's not tapered.
There's no acorn or anything. It's a flat flange.
Because that's been a discussion on either SF Baja or one of the other off-road groups on Facebook about somebody that lost a tire. And people are like, check your lug nuts. Make sure you have the right lug nuts. A lot of people get aftermarket tires and they don't get the right lug nuts.
Well, and there's different angles to So if you get the wrong ones, they will work themselves loose.
Wallow themselves out. Yep. Yeah, exactly. So this is a good PSA we're rolling into here.
So I'm looking around and, you know, Amazon's got some cheaper stuff. And I'm like, no, this ain't going to fly. There you go. The more you know. So I found Dorman, who does a lot of aftermarket stuff, OEM for vehicles.
Right.
And they had a nice solid one piece with threads all the way through lug nut. And I'm like, okay, I'm going to get those. You know, it was about $100 for 32. Well, I got 30 lug nuts.
Hashtag Jason.
There's 32. Well, you know, you don't fuck around when you've got a tow rig. I don't want to be sitting on the side of the road.
No, absolutely. Losing a tire is absolutely the worst thing.
Not a good thing. So, and these lug nuts I had were compromised and I'm like, nope. So, got those put on, everything torqued down, 165 foot pounds of torque. So I had to get my big snap-on freaking torque wrench out. Would have been nice to have a gear wrench,
fancy
plug into my phone and
$2,000 digital wrench.
Send an email to Ford knowing that my lug nuts are properly torqued. But anyways, Corey. Did that. Boom. Went and drove around. I've driven, I don't know, 6-7 times on it and just retorqued them again this morning.
Uh-huh.
So we're good to go.
Cool.
Yep. So anyways, that's the tow rig update. So that's ready to go. I still got a couple things to do on the camper and buggy, and hopefully I can get those done tomorrow, and then I will be ready for trek vehicle-wise, and then it's just a matter of packing.
Well, there you go.
Pack it up, pack it in. Let us begin.
Well, while Jason was talking about Ford, I had interesting news from Ford Corporate came out about they announced... Big time announcement. I'm not a Ford fan, but I like new cool vehicles and I've never been a fan. When the Raptor came out with the V6, the EcoBoost, it was, you know, powerful and whatnot, but it just didn't sound right. So Ford has introduced or announced the F-150 Raptor R.
Yarr, matey.
So they're bringing the V8 back and it's going to be badass. It's, to be the most powerful F-150 Raptor ever. It's got the new 5.2 liter supercharged V8.
Wow.
Cranks out a whopping 700 horsepower. And 640 foot-pounds of torque. And it's going to be badass. It's not going to be cheap.
No, they're coming out hot there. $100,000 or so, probably.
A little over $100,000. But, you know, the way these niche vehicles have been just being announced and selling out, there's just so much money floating around out there that people are snapping these things up. Now, whether they're actually driving them and wheeling them or running them off-road or they're just sticking them in their freaking garage and just drooling over the fucking things, I don't know.
Yeah.
But I think they're going to be around $109,000 to start. And I would expect them to be, you know, selling for actually $140 to $150.
There's going to be a dealer premium markup and all that good stuff.
Yeah. So, I mean, just no different than the Lightning or the Ranger Raptor or the Bronco Raptor. You know, I mean, all these niche vehicles are
Velociraptor
was selling like hotcakes. You know, obviously it started with the TRX from Ram. And that TRX is badass. I mean, that thing, I see a few of them on the freeway and they snarl, man. They're just badass. It's 6.4 liter V8 with supercharger on it. Just goes like a raped ape. Yeah. So anyway, it's just kind of cool impressive. How all these manufacturers are up in their game and kind of waiting, you know, just crickets from, no, that's wrong.
Whoa, that's not the one.
Crickets from Chevrolet with the high horsepower stuff. I don't think they've kicked down anything good. But, there you go. So Jason's put his order in for a Raptor R.
I wish, man. I am, financially things are not good and trying to reevaluate my, my steed here of thinning the herd and, hopefully sell the house and lower my payments here.
You just buy some land and live in your camper.
Well, I thought about that, but it's a cab over camper, so it's kind of small. So I'd have to get, you know, at least a travel trailer or something. Get
10 or 12 easy ups, and then you're all set.
You do that, too. I mean, there's some pretty good homeless encampments down the road here.
That's right.
Pretty nice, you know.
But you'd be surrounded by a bunch of cars, you know.
Seen a lot of them been burning up lately. So
that's right, like in Oakland. Holy smokes.
Jeez, these people.
Yep. Well, I think Tyler said he was going to cancel all of his other orders and put an order in for a Raptor R, but, you know, Tyler's rolling in dough.
Oh,
so.
Man, he's printing money over there. Yeah, that's good. He might be the new Chris money. Now do we go hashtag Tyler money?
Chris is broke, too.
I know.
IRS.
What about Jimmy? Jimmy's vacationing all over the world. We just do hashtag Jimmy money.
Right, or hashtag, well, Jimmy's got COVID.
Let's just
right
call
now
it snail trail money.
That's right, hashtag snail trail.
Oh, he just wanted to take more time off. That's all that is.
Hang out with his wife. And,
exactly.
And, yeah.
Yeah. No, he does have the vid, so.
It's going around, man. The president's even got it right
now. I'm going to call, oh, jeez, that's. And he's vaccinated, right?
Well, yeah, triple. And he's taking that Paxlovid. I mean, of course, he gets all the best.
So
shit.
I was going to say, so choose your words wisely, Jason.
Outside voice. Be good. Be a good boy.
Exactly right. He has the access to the best healthcare known to humankind.
Him and his clone.
And he's fully, and his clone. And he's fully vaccinated, you know, just, you know, he's very well protected. And I'm sure I hope he gets medical attention every day because he needs it.
Does he have to wait in line for medical care?
No, I'm pretty sure he doesn't. And he's still got the vid. So,
yep,
there you go. And I don't know. I mean, does he really have it? I don't know.
Well,
you could just, you know, theory about all kinds of stuff, but I just,
well, we don't generally get into politics in this show.
No,
at least that type of politics.
As bad as I want him out of office, I don't want second in charge in office either. So it's
no.
it could be worse, but I don't think it could. I don't know.
Cackling Kamala.
Yeah, but this whole administration is a fucking joke, and somebody I cannot fathom, and whatever side you're on, I cannot fathom that. This is actually happening, that people are letting this happen.
Oh, I know.
Well, because, you know, they're just puppets.
They keep voting.
Well, no, it has nothing. As you know, votes don't mean dick. It's what the agenda is. And I cannot believe that somebody's actually letting this happen. And I'll leave it at that.
Well, the weakening of the United States. But anyway, Jimmy, we hope you get better quick and, you know, get over the COVID. And get back.
Let's go, Brandon.
Let's go, Brandon.
Let's go, Jimmy.
Yeehaw! So yeah, that's the news about the Raptor R. And if any of our listeners are going to put in an order for one, and you're local and you get it, we'd love to go for a ride and check it out. So.
Yeah, you know, I'm a little disappointed I didn't get to drive the Rivian.
They didn't offer you to drive the Rivian?
No, she offered, and, you know, we got so wrapped up in the day. That was trail maintenance day, so
right.
Adopt a trail on. And then, you know, I was like, damn, you know, I don't know anybody else with a Raptor. So, Shelby, if you're listening, I want to drive your, I'm sorry, not Raptor, Rivian. Starts with an R.
Yeah, right.
Can I buy a vowel?
Well, R is not an R.
All right. What else we got here? Oh, so IG's been, I've been cranking out the reels, right? Just trying to get a reel out a day to see
right.
what happens. And we have picked up a lot of followers where some of these reels are taken off. Ultra Fort Jones and I did a reel. He's like, hey, do you still have that video of, you know, climbing up that hill and launching? I go, yeah, I can find it. And boom, there we found it. And then so collaborated on that.
Yep.
That
was cool.
It's been fun. My favorite one. And it started off so slow was the stair steps at Hollister and that Ford Ranger. Those kids that were stock mobbing. You know, they probably bought that thing the weekend before for $200 and just beating the living crap out of this Ranger.
Right. It was pretty beat.
And Ultra Four Jones and I were at the top of stair steps.
Right.
This was during the clinic.
I was at the bottom.
And they, yeah, in between, you know, students coming through and these guys come barreling in, hauling ass like Bo and Luke Duke
shit
into the
bouncing around on the bed.
Oh, yeah. And I'm like, oh, get the cameras ready for this and film that. And then so you hear these songs or, you know, sound bite snippets on IG. And I heard that one where, you know, Trump going, write it like a cowboy. And I'm like, oh, I got a video for that.
There you go.
And put that to it, and it dropped it, and it like got 1,000, 1,200, 1,500 views. And I'm like, okay, whatever. I think it's freaking hilarious.
Uh-huh.
And then all of a sudden, it started trending, and boom, it's like at 90,000 views now.
Holy crap.
It's the second video. So when you click on a song, like on IG, and there's a reel, and at the bottom left of the screen there, you can click on the song or soundbite, and then it will go into... it'll open up a whole nother page that all the reels that were made from that snippet or soundbite. And yeah, we're in the number two spot there. So that's really freaking epic.
That's badass.
It's fun. It's just fun to watch it go. Cole Johnson reached out to me, and he says, "Hey, I see you have an SXOR buggy, and you need a new hood."
Okay.
And yeah. I'm like, yes, I do. And then I started putting two and two together, and I go, wait a minute. They're part of BC Customs / SXOR buggies.
Okay.
So BC Customs builds these military vehicles. So same similar chassis to my buggy, these mid-engine vehicles, and they're building them for the military. They got a military contract. So they stopped building rock buggies a while back.
Okay.
They still build a few here and there. But him and his brother, Sky, raced at KOH last year, and I had no knowledge of this.
And 4,800?
I 4,400. So they have IFS, they put an IFS front end in there.
Okay.
Independent front suspension. And so he's Cole Johnson on IG there, 4482. Sky Johnson is 4425, are their race numbers. And then there's SXOR Motorsports. But I was like, holy crap. So I'd been looking for a new hood.
Right.
Tried to get one from the Campbells. Talked to Tammy. She was going to, you know, hook me up and bring it out to Prairie City.
Right. You know,
because they had the semi truck out there at Prairie City for the race, the Ultra 4 Stampede race.
Right,
And it didn't get loaded up. You know, okay, fine. It's a fiberglass hood, Liberty style hood. And I'm like, well, I got to take the hood off when I... put fuel in it because the fuel tank's in the front.
Correct.
And I'm like, man, I love this Lexon plastic hood that I have. It's lightweight, easy, take on and off. And so Cole reached out to me and he goes, hey, I noticed you got the buggy and you got a cracked hood. Do you want a new hood? You need a new hood.
You need a new hood.
I'm like, oh my gosh, yes, I do. And I want a new hood. And how do I get one? He goes, yeah, we just had a bunch made and yeah, I can ship one out to you. So... Then he said the shipping was like $300. I'm like, oh my gosh, for like a 4 foot wide box, right? For this hood by 3.5 feet.
Well, everything's gotten stupid expensive.
Oh, I'm like, oh my gosh. Well, what is it to send to Nevada? And it was like $250 to send to Nevada, or $150 plus $100 for the hood, whatever. And then so I'm like, okay, that's more palatable. And then I thought, oh my gosh, I got to call my crazy buddy Dan that I just posted the video of him like he's dancing, and that's up at the top of Windchill 5 at Trek.
Right.
Right? And he's got that badass S10.
All tubed up.
It's tubed out. It's not an S10 anymore, but he wheels that. He's got 43 stickies on that thing. He just
is that four-wheel steer now?
No. It might be now. It wasn't at the time.
It wasn't at the time.
And, he doesn't have a gas pedal. He's got an on-off switch on the dash. It's either full on or full off. So
hence, we call him Crazy Dan.
Yeah, it's Crazy Dan. So anyways, I was texting with him tonight, and I go, dude, you live in Utah. How far are you from this place? Come to find out, he knows Brandon, the father of Sky and Cole, and
well, that's convenient.
Yeah, and he goes, yeah, I can pick up your hood and bring it with me to Trek. I'm like, done. Here you go. It's all
sweet.
I'll get you some whiskey, Dan. So that's pretty cool. So we're gonna have Cole and Sky on the podcast.
Yes, sir.
And hear the whole story of the SXOR buggy. So Sky Extreme Off-Road is how it started. His dad started it, Brandon, then got this military contract. And obviously, that's a very lucrative way to run a business if you can get a military contract.
For sure, yeah.
So they went that direction. But I want to hear about them racing and all that stuff. And I think that would be a lot of fun. So look for that coming up here. Hopefully soon.
Yeah.
Get them make it piped in here on Riverside.
Piped in.
Yeah. So you got anything over there? You want me to keep going?
Oh boy.
Careful.
Sheet down. You can keep going. I just wanted to talk about how, we talked about the Raptor R, and I talked about how the crazy, how these specialty vehicles are selling and whatnot, and the pricing is just over the top. One of the things that I also was noticing is, you know, Ford's really super, super popular about their fancy, you know, off-road rigs and whatnot, but they also have gotten, the Maverick, small little pickup truck, the one that's smaller than the Ranger, has, really picked up and sold out. It's become super popular. And what's going on with the Maverick is that, the pricing on that has gotten a little crazy now too. First of all, they're not accepting any new orders for the Maverick, but at the same time, there's some dealers that are, I guess you can get a Maverick for like $22,000 if you order it.
What?
But now there are dealers that are marking them up $22,000. So it's like the price of two Mavericks for the price of one.
That's ridiculous.
So, I mean, and then it just kind of goes into the whole, you know, shrinkflation is being bandied about on the media right now about, you know, supermarkets, if you go and you buy ice cream. We've talked about this on the show, about how packaging of different products is shrinking. It's just the term for that is shrinkflation. It's a thing now. So,
and I do look at that now, you know, because you're comparing products on the shelf or whatever, and you look at the ounce, and then like I know Safeway does like an ounce price per ounce,
correct,
which is helpful as well. So it's like sometimes, you know, is it worth buying the bigger product that's typically a little bit more less per ounce, but then if the smaller product's on sale, you could buy two of those smaller products, get the same amount for even less.
Right.
So there you go.
Well, then, I mean, one of the things,
the more you know,
ice cream we talked about, but now peanut butter, if you look at the bottom of a lot of jars, you'll see that they've got an indentation or a dimple in them now. So the exterior packaging, this part that you normally see when it's on the shelf,
looks the same.
Looks exactly the same, but there's less product in there, and the price, of course, has changed.
So it's got like a punt in the bottom, like a wine bottle.
Exactly.
We talked about what a punt is in the past podcast, so listen back.
That's correct. So, I mean,
165 episodes prior to this.
Yeah, listen to all of them, and if you like it, make sure you share it with your friends. So
exactly.
But this is as consumers, we all need to be aware of this. And the other thing that I noticed, and Tyler disagrees, and Jason apparently does too. I was driving by a gas station yesterday, and I looked over at the price board. You know, they have those digital price boards, and it said for mid-grade unleaded, it said $6 a gallon. Exactly $6.00 per gallon. I was like,
okay.
In all my years, and I'm a little older, I have never seen a 00 on a gas price at a gas station. It's always been like $5.99. Everything's always ended in a 9. You know, $5.99, $4.99. Back in the day when I was a kid, 79 cents a gallon, 99 cents a gallon. Ooh. Yeah,
you had to crank start the cars?
Yeah, exactly. We had to go out with a. It was an old Model T, but I mean, it just blew my mind that I had never seen that before. And obviously, you know, we're all getting screwed at the pump.
Yes,
and it hurts, and it definitely has impacted our summer plans or our travel plans. I know my wife and I have discussions about where we want to go and what we want to do. And
we start picking and choosing. Well, yeah, I have to.
Yeah, absolutely. So, I mean, shit, every time you pull up to the pump, especially with our diesel's the most expensive, you know, fuel product out there right now.
And it comes off. They're raping us on diesel because that's the least expensive fuel to produce. It comes off first.
Exactly.
It's not as refined as, it's so stupid. Anyways.
So, but that's just kind of the whole, you know, I'd almost would categorize what I just went through as a little bit of a rant, but, you know, yeah, it is what it is right now.
I don't think you dropped the F-bomb, so it's not a rant.
Fuck.
Oh, there you go. There you go. Good.
So, yeah, that's kind of what I've got for today. We're, chugging away. Do you want?
I got a couple more things here.
Okay, go ahead.
So we've got Gear Wrench, you know, Corey threw out our phone number as, you know, people, the best debt collection.
Dude, they're
voicemail that comes
these
in.
These collectors are aggressive.
They are very aggressive. But before that, I will mention, I mentioned it before, Trail Hero, but it's coming up quick in October. I can't wait. October 3rd through the 8th is the actual event date, so Monday through Saturday. You know, you can go to trailhero.com, get signed up. I've been in talks with Rich Klein, that's the head of Trail Hero there in Hurricane, Utah.
Right.
It's pronounced Hurricane, not Hurricane, Hurricane.
Okay.
Livery. Did we ever confirm that? Livery.
No.
Livery.
Tomato, tomato.
Okay, potato, potato. So.
Hurricane Utah.
Rich is going to be on the podcast coming up here and dropping bombs, but they announced here this week that Colt Ford.
I saw that.
Crap music, right? Country rap.
Yep. But
we have a connection to Colt Ford through one of my dear friends, Tom, and there's a whole story that people that know. But it's great. He's just a down to earth guy. We got to meet him in concert before he played in Wheatland.
That's right.
There was a group of like 30 of us, and he spent time with us. He changed his song set for us.
Oh, cool.
It's just super cool. He was trying to make it on the PGA Tour, didn't make it, and then he started this singing career and hit a niche. And his songs are great and pretty funny. Some of them get a little rappy out there, but
that's true.
But there's a lot of good beats, and he's done some, duets with other country singers, famous country singers. It's pretty great. So he's done well for himself. But he is going to be there at Trail Hero Friday night.
Awesome.
Along with other country artists. So this Trail Hero is shaping up to be something else. I mean, not only is the wheeling phenomenal. The venue is phenomenal. You know, you got something to do for the whole family. There's right. The beach, lake, you know, stuff where the kids can go out and play.
The whole town.
Then the town itself is cool.
Yeah.
I mean, you can drive your buggy to Walmart.
Okay.
Maybe frowned upon, but not too bad. They're not going to pull you over. At least we weren't. you got the resort right there. So if you want to be all bougie, and you know, your wife, girlfriend, significant other, whatever your deal is, they don't want to camp on the beach, or they don't want to be in an RV. You can be in a nice accommodations,
Airbnbs, there's
Airbnbs. The houses are nice. I went and visited some friends that were staying at some houses that they Airbnb, VRBO'd, whatever. But the resort itself is super plush. Got the pool, got a couple golf courses there,
right?
Nice restaurant. So it is a destination, and the wheeling is everything from mild to the most extreme wild. Some of the wildest stuff I have ever seen.
From 1 to 15.
It is 1 to 15, and it's a joke. Doing nines and tens in my buggy is super intense, and it's fun, but it's scary at the same time. So, and then you got a four steer buggy, then the world's your oyster out there. But man,
right?
A drag axle, us drag axle guys have to work it. But it's very doable. But it's great because most of the trails we went out last year. You know, my buddy Tom and his Bronco. He's got a well set up Bronco, but he didn't want to be laying it up against the sides, beating up his body or anything.
Right. No, it's
so
classic.
On those extreme obstacles. You know, Kobe was there with us and stuff, and his LJ and. You know, we could go play, the buggies could go in these hard lines and get all jacked up and have to winch out or whatever, you know, or work it in 15 minutes to get through this obstacle. And they could go right up round and watch us. And it's just, right. It's super cool. Most trails are like that. There's some you get into these canyons and it's one way in, one way out, and you're committed. But anyways, check out Trail Hero. If you haven't signed up, go. You will not be disappointed. I know a lot of the runs are filling up fast.
Sure.
And if you sign, I mean, they got all kinds of the buggy pass. I think the hardcore pass. It's $200. Their runs are $50 each, but $50 each. So I usually sign up for 3 or 4 runs. So there's $150, $200 right there.
Right.
And with the hardcore pass, they give you a map to trails that are new there that the general public doesn't know about. So they give you maps to these newer trails, all the hard trails, You know, 8, 9, 10 and up. And then you get entered into a drawing for 5 BFG tires. And yes, you can choose stickies if you want.
Cool.
And all kinds of stuff. So anyways, there's a lot of options. Side by sides, you got a golf cart. You want to go play golf, you can go play golf. And you can drive your golf cart to go play golf, to get in a real golf cart and drive the course. But they got something for everybody there. So check it out. Sign up. Look forward to Rich coming on the podcast and talking about other exciting stuff that's coming down the pipeline. All
new announcements for 2022 Trail Hero. Yeah. So if you, I don't think I have the website here, but you can Google Trail Hero and it'll take you right to the website.
Yep. Trailhero.com.
Sweet.
All right. So now voicemails.
Yeah, so we got to do this giveaway, we're not giving anything away. We're going to say who can get. We're going to announce a winner, and then Gear Wrench Corey is going to give something away.
Right.
So let's.
So we picked our top three in an honorable mention.
That's correct.
Right. So we're going to start with our honorable mention. All right. So I need to cue this up here. Stand by.
Standing by.
So let me play. He had to redo it. So let me start with this one.
Hi, this is the Shitbox Collection Agency. We are calling on behalf of Snail Trail 4x4 and Gear Wrench Tools. Gear Wrench Tools has agreed to generously donate the fine you owe.
What happened, James? So he called back. So here's a good one right here.
Hi, this is the Shitbox Collection Agency. We are calling on behalf of Snail Trail 4x4 and Gear Wrench Tools. Gear Wrench Tools has agreed to generously donate the fines you owe to I Wish I Had a Jeep, a.k.a. Jeep and Jimmy. He can't handle the torques anymore and can't keep up on Jeep trails because Toyota's stuck. Do what's right. Pay the fines. Samurai James out.
Nice.
Wow.
All right. That was
very good.
That was great. Okay. That was our honorable mention there. All right. So in third place. Let's see. So he's got two here. Which one did we pick? I think it was this one. Here we go. Moderator, ready?
Right.
Hey, this is Rover Dunn's Italian cousin. Calling from my friend Gear Wrench Corey. Says you owe him some money. Got a message for you. Says that's a pretty nice podcast you got over there. It'd be a shame if something was to happen to it. Know what I mean? Now, that's about all I got to say. One last thing. Toyota sucks.
That's great.
That's awesome. That was number three, right?
That was three. So that was Rover Dawn. So he had a little follow up. We'll go ahead and let's play that.
Okay.
All right. Let's go in here.
Yeah, hey, it's your buddy Rover Dawn here. Just want to say, don't worry about my Italian cousin. He's not good. Sometimes he forgets his lines. He should probably practice those things first. But that's okay. We forgive him because he always remembers the important stuff, and that's that Toyota suck. That's all.
Love you, Don.
Oh, boy. Go. That's great.
That's awesome. That's so good. All right. So that was our third place.
Third place. Number two.
Honorable mention. Third place. Okay, so now we're going to roll into numero dos, number two. All right. And so for numero dos, our runner-up here, runner-up, first place loser.
first loser.
Hey, g'day. I think we need to introduce ourselves. It's Down Under Collections here.
Down Under Collections.
We've been commissioned by Snail Trail and Gear Wrench Corey to collect a debt, apparently long overdue. We make Boba Fett look pretty ordinary, so unless you want to be encased in carbonite and dragged back to Gory.
Carbonite?
Pay the bill.
Carmite.
Gotcha.
I think carmite's some something. It's Australian, obviously.
Well, I think he said carbonite.
That's, I don't think it's carbonite.
He thinks we're Han Solo, carmite. And he's in a from Star carmite? Wars, and he's in a case of carbonite.
Encased in carbonite and dragged back to Gory. Pay the bill.
Gotcha. You're Han Solo.
I don't know.
I think you're Han. So you're going to be encased in carbonite. That's going to suck for you.
Wow. All right. But I like. So they called early June, and then they followed up later June. I like that the debt collectors followed up. Right.
I don't like that.
So here we go. Here's a follow up from Down Under Collections.
More aggressive, probably.
Down Under Collections. All right. Here we are.
Yeah, hi. It's Aaron here from Down Under Debt Collection Service. We've just got a proposal for you in regard to this outstanding debt with Gear Inch Corey, that if you submit that the payment that you're supposed to do to him and supply it to me, I will then take good care of it and go and use it to buy you guys some top quality Australian whiskey and bourbon to wow. send over to you guys. If this is a appropriate deal, we can make it happen for you.
I like it.
That's a hell of an offer.
I like it. Okay. See? They're working with us. See?
Yeah.
They want to get that debt paid off. All right. Well, so that was great. So that was our buddy Charles, I think, down in Down Under Collections in Australia. Thanks, Charles, for calling in.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, so our number one. This was very creative. I liked, and he did call back as well. We like the callbacks, just to know that you were in it to win it. You know. So let me see if I can find this one. Let's see.
So we're gonna play the winner, the number one pick.
This is our number one pick. The winner. Here we go. Ready?
Hold on.
Number one for the Gear Wrench Corey contest.
Yes.
Debt collection. We only want a whiskey
debt
collection.
Did they decide what the prize is going to be?
I heard it's going to be some stubby wrenches because wow. Jimmy can't get them. That's what I heard.
Well, Jimmy's not tall enough to handle.
This message is for Wheeling Wine and Whiskey. Good afternoon. My name is Michael Klein, and I'm a debt collector with Gear Wrench Tools. Your bill payment is past the due date. Based on our records, the total outstanding balance of $5,834.10 is overdue. We have tried contacting you 7 times during the last 2 weeks.
7 times?
Please call us at 916-345-4744 when you get some free time. Also, let us know the status of your payment or if you have any questions. Thank you for your time and attention.
So that's very nice, you know.
We ain't sending no stinking payment.
Very nice.
I ain't paying you squat.
And then we got a follow-up.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to hell.
This message, once again, it's for Wheeling Wine and Whiskey. This is Michael Klein, debt collector for Gear Wrench Tools. We are calling to inform you that after continuing violations, late fees, and asshole tax, your current balance is now $7,321.45.
It's escalating.
We have made many failed attempts to contact you over the past few months. At this time, we have no other recourse but to petition for the liquidation of the following asset.
Uh-oh.
One so-called Studio L and its contents, including but not limited to, one...
Oh.
Uh-oh.
...including koozie stickers and t-shirts, an autographed photo of Tyler Lawson and James Black, and a case of Old Elk blended straight bourbon. Please call us at 916-345-4744 so we can settle this account. Otherwise, we will have no other choice but to alert the authorities of your harboring of a criminal fugitive from the Mexican government.
Wow.
Have a great day and keep calling.
Is that Lorenzo? Oh, my gosh.
I think they wanted a picture. They want a picture of Jimmy and Tyler and sumo wrestler outfits.
Signed picture and then Studio L and its contents. So that means all your bourbon
and a t-shirt.
I got the t-shirt part, and then it got a little broke up, yeah, and then it went to the signed picture.
Probably wanted James a YJ Black too, or something.
Tyler Larson. There you go. Well,
you ain't
there you
getting
go.
Anything from me. You can, from my cold. You have to peel it from my cold dead hands.
Well, I thought that was pretty damn creative.
Yeah.
And they called back within, you know, 12 days of the original. So there you go. So I believe that was Mike Klein that said he was calling in. Mike Klein, you are the winner. We will get information to Gear Wrench Corey, and then he can send you the Gear Wrench prize. So that's pretty awesome.
That is awesome.
Yeah. So that was fun.
That was a fun contest, and who knew? I mean, there was just by saying Allen wrenches.
I think there was about a dozen entries here, and unfortunately, one of them, the cell connection was so bad we couldn't even play it. So I apologize there, but there was some good creative stuff there, but we wanted to give our top three an honorable mention. So there you go. Yeah, we haven't played the Toyota banging off the rev limiter lately. That's a good one.
That's a good one, right?
I like that one. So, I think we're getting caught up here finally, Chris, with everything all the business.
I mean, we got a new giveaway coming up soon too distant future. So
I think we should start that one. We'll start that one in August. That'll be our August giveaway. Because then we'll be up at Trek, and then we can come back, and then we can pick a winner and announce a winner at the end of the month. So
yeah, we'll have all sorts of Trek stories to get caught up with. And
then the winner can bring that prize to Trail Hero.
That's right.
It'd be very useful on any trail.
Absolutely. So you got anything else?
I don't think so. Let me just go through the notes. No, that's taken care of. Lorenzo's on his meds. We got that. Okay, it's good.
You let him out of his cage or what?
Yeah. I got to take that roll of pennies to the bank so I have something in my account. Nope, looks like we're all caught up here.
All right.
So
well,
look for us coming up. Get signed up for Trek if you haven't yet. Got to make that happen. Trail Hero, those are our next two events. Like I say, we've been a little picky choosy here with the fuel prices, and we get it, man.
We're going to open up the enrollment for clinic here pretty quick, for fall clinic.
Oh, that's a good one. So, yeah, third weekend in September is the Esprit de Force Safety Clinic. You can go to 4x4safety.org and sign up. That should open up here.
Truck Fest. It's right after Truck Fest.
Really quick. Stay tuned for that. Look on that. It will fill up within like 3-4 days. It fills up.
For sure. For sure.
We take 50, 55 students, and you got to get in. Got to get in early if you want to get in on the safety clinic. So I think we got a lot of the holdovers taken care of in May, which was good.
It's a great value.
From COVID and all that stuff. So everybody will have a shot at it. And then the nice thing about September, it's usually a little cooler at Hollister. So
yeah,
check it out. One day, 4x4 safety clinic. It's for anybody and everybody off-roading.
That's right.
And any vehicle with a four-wheel drive and a transfer case.
So low range.
A two-speed transfer case with low range, because we've had to specify that.
You need to have low range.
Yeah. The CRV snuck in one clinic, and that was it actually did pretty good, but so if you or anybody you know wants some hands-on safety training off-road at Hollister Hills.
Relatively local.
Third weekend of September. Well, we've had people travel from far, far away.
Yeah, I know. We've had people come from Washington State.
Doesn't matter.
Nevada. So
love to see Charles out there from Australia.
That'd be
hell of a commute.
Yeah. Pull in with his, what does he have, a Toyota? Probably a Toyota, huh?
Or a
Nissan.
That?
I'm not sure.
I don't know.
He'll correct us. He'll be pretty violent about it.
Yeah.
Well, as collecting. So sorry, Charles. Yeah,
come get the collection there. Straight up.
So if you want to send email to Jason or Chris, it's Jason or Chris at WheelingWineWhiskey.com. Don't forget about our Instagram, which is WheelingWineWhiskey.
Got to hit up the gram there.
You can DM Jason there if you decide to do a 5-star review on iTunes or Apple Podcast. DM Jason so he can send you some stickers and a
ride it. They say ride it like a cowboy. Just ride it. Ride that sucker right through.
Wow. I have to mute that shit.
That's a good one there. I like that. Ride it. Ride it like a cowboy.
So don't forget about our website, wheelingwinewhiskey.com, where you can see all of our past episodes, and there's photographs, and there's also, of course, links to our merch and links to Irate 4x4, which is where you can sign up for the forums at irate4x4.com. If you decide you want to support the show, you can also sign up with the Wheeling Wine Whiskey to be in our barrel society there, and that's super easy to do also.
Yeah.
Now
Austin's made it super easy.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. And it's still the $5, $10, and $20 tiers. So you have the Wheeling 101, you have the Barrel.
Tell a friend.
Barrel Club, and then, of course, you've got the Old Elk Club, which is our top tier. And last but not least, don't forget about our phone number, 408-800-5169.
408-800-5169. And one more parting shot here. I want to see this video blow up. I love this one.
Okay.
With the Jonah Hill in there.
Oh, wow.
With the music. This is good. I'm going to have to put that on the soundtrack for the buggy.
Perfect.
You know, get into the Rubicon there.
So,
Fordyce going up windshield 5.
That's right. That's right.
Boots and
so if you
pants
like the show.
Boots and pants.
Spread the word. Tell a friend. Tell them you like the show. And tell them to give it a listen. And if they like it, tell them to obviously spread the word. Continue it on.
Spread the love.
Spread the love. Absolutely. And on that
note,
we're out.